Boeing shares are down sharply after a series of analyst downgrades. Down 4%, UBS and Credit Suisse both downgraded the stock. It's the emergence of the shocking messages sent by Boeing staff testing new systems on the jet, the 737 MAX, and the revelation that Boeing knew, or the suggestion knew, about the problems before it entered service. The company's expressed regret at how the pilots' comments were released, adding they reflected a reaction to a simulator program that was not functioning properly and that was still undergoing testing. Paul LaMonica is with me. Isn't the reality, Paul, that, putting it crudely, Boeing's explanation for those comments, they might be true, they might not? The market's basically saying, we don't know.
Yeah, I think the market is obviously very concerned by the fact that these messages have come to light. They were from 2016, and they are obviously pretty unfortunate in light of these two tragedies involving 737 MAX planes. You have one test pilot clearly talking about some of the reservations that he felt were limitations in the software, and that is obviously an area that I think regulators are going to be focusing on when they investigate these two crashes. So it is obviously not good for Boeing that these messages have come to light. They are trying to restore confidence, and that's why, you know, one of the analysts that you referred to, Credit Suisse, they downgraded the stock today and said that it's going to be a trouble, I think, for customers. Why would anyone want to fly one of these Boeing planes again when every major news outlet, including ours, has reported out these messages and see the paper trail, if you will, of what some of the concerns that pilots had with Boeing planes before they were put into service?
Which raises the issue, of course, what Boeing does about it. And then, you've got several issues. Firstly, does Muhlenberg survive? Does he keep his job as CEO? Secondly, do you rebrand the 737 MAX, call it something else, and hope nobody notices? Or three, once it's back in the air, does it even matter? But I noticed today that Reuters has a comment from the Europeans saying that they will probably bring the plane back into service sometime early next year, but after the US does.
Yes, that is the report from Reuters. It's important to note that that Reuters report apparently came out before the revelation of these messages, these internal messages that now have come to light, that really call into question just when any of these planes will be back in service internationally at all. I think, to your other points, does Muhlenberg survive? Obviously, he's already been stripped of the chairman title, and there are some calls for him to step down as CEO. We've seen, obviously, other scandal-ridden CEOs have to fall on their sword, so to speak. And we could get some new news as early as Wednesday morning. That's when Boeing is going to report in its latest earnings. I don't think anyone's going to really care about this quarter's numbers. It's all going to be about what the company says on the call about the 737 MAX, when it might be back in the air, and what the impact on profits for 2020 and beyond will be because of this crisis.